What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my laboratory where safety is number one priority, especially today because we're going to be working with the chainsaws. Obviously, chainsaws are one of the most dangerous tools. Remember, be safe. Anyways, we took down this tree, a big one. It died almost like a year and a half ago. But when it fell, as you can see, there is a lot of laying logs in the grass. Very dangerous to cut like that because I don't see if there is another rock or is another piece of log. This is a lot of danger of kickback. So today I'm gonna put to the test a pretty cool tool. It's called like a sawhorse for the logs, but it attaches the chainsaw in. So let's see what it looks like, and also we'll try to do it on a hill over here. Hopefully it will be pretty steady. So as you can see, it's pretty small to where it just puts in the back of a side-by-side, just like that. Grab it and carry it down wherever you need to. Hopefully not too far that you have to hike with it. So boom, that's what I'm gonna be working over here. A little bit overgrown, but that's okay. Let's see if this sawhorse log holder will help me. By the way, this is the brand of this sawhorse. So we're gonna put it in, the chainsaw into here, and then screw this together and make it really, really tight. And as you can see, it won't damage the blade of the chainsaw. You just stick it in, level it good to where it's not touching the metal red piece, and then you can just adjust it too slowly. There you go. Probably best to do it with a 16 inch chainsaw, but we're gonna try it with this one as well. Also, just grab your tool to tighten this up, just like that. Makes it really steady in there. Okay, let's start it out. Obviously it will work way better on asphalt of some sort, level surface, but I want to use it where my tree is have fallen. So what I'm gonna do is start it. The chainsaw should be hot, so it should start pretty easily. I'm gonna open that. By the way, right here is a guard, so you can adjust that.
Yeah.
far so good. I need to readjust this side here because it's hitting the blade. So sometimes you just have to unscrew this, and this is really tight, so you will need your tool to open it, untie it all the way so you can readjust it. So I got lifted to the side, so maybe a little bit more down. It got pushed up, I guess, on a bigger logs or something, but this is definitely a really fast way to do it. Okay, let's talk about this thing a little bit. As you can see, it is very uncomfortable, almost tilted to the side a little bit, and very bad terrain on a hill. I found the flattest part over here. Tried to put the log under, that kind of didn't work. It still stands really steady. I like that it folds easily. It was really easy to bring it down from here. It'll be really horrible to bring up all the firewood back up over there. Maybe I should set this up over there and bring up little logs up there and cut it up. But I really wanted to put it to the test in a bad terrain. And as you can see, it works really well. I'm super tall, so it's a bit uncomfortable for me. But again, if you at least 6 foot, you'll have no problem using this thing. Still very, very nice. Look at that. 16 inches probably would work even better because it won't be sticking out over here. You can push it back a little bit, but yeah, hopefully nobody's standing on this side anyways. I don't think you're supposed to. And yeah, this is just like a guard. There you go. This is how it works. Very smart. I think my blade a little bit crooked or something. That's why it's not in the middle. I think it's my chainsaw fault, but it still works. This chainsaw is kind of getting old anyways. So yeah, as you can see, I have a lot of branches that fell down into pieces like that, which is kind of dangerous to cut on the ground. So I can bring one branch at a time or cut it up here. Very, very nice. Look how many I have. I'm just gonna keep doing it. Look, another branch right here. Look at that. Cutting that on the grass like that, dangerous. So bring it back up here and just lay it down here. I wouldn't do anything longer than that, but yeah, very comfortable. You don't have to hold chainsaw. This is actually not as exhausting. You kind of just stand in here, cut it up, take a break, bring another one. Super nice. Pieces like that, you will have to cut in half or three times, so that way it's not going to be so heavy. Like this one, I cut off in two pieces, this one probably another two pieces, and I can do it on a sawhorse now, and it's still pretty thick logs. Let's do another couple shots and I'll be done. I think I'm done. I think this thing is amazing. You know, if you cut a lot of firewood, I think it's a must have. Makes it so much easier and less dangerous, in my opinion. Again, you got practice too. Next one, I'm gonna show you how easy it is to take it off. Just pull this up. Probably use gloves, chainsaw will be hot. So, and just pull it out and spin it some more. So that way it's pushed out really, really easily, and you got your chainsaw. Boom, very nice. Love this. And by the way, this side here is a safety, so that way the log don't fall on you, and also chainsaw doesn't go any farther, just in case. And one more time to show you guys how easy it is. Folds together, boom. Grab it like that, tear it out. Very, very skinny and thin. This too, readjust. you can push it forward so it's not in the way, just to keep yourself away from the chainsaw. And I'm gonna go bring it back up the hill.